当时偶遇石头城的时候，是发现石头城，因为它的交通不便，也是因为住在这里这些纳西民族的这种意识，把这一块土地保持的相对来说是比较完整的一个农耕文化和纳西文化的一个系统。那我们想挖掘一下，就像这样的系统，它到底它的生存下来的秘密是什么？
我们乡民就是牧师的，就大量的去修田，然后这个合适的这个居民的话就是去修渠，最后的话就是通过育了一头牛，然后牺牲着这个所有的土地和所有的孙渠，得合理的食欲。 我们当时土孙渠的话就是有三道古垒。 一个古垒是生产雨水，调古垒是它的生活雨水，这样一个承载着这个生存者的这个消防雨水的古垒。我们的村渠的管理制像村规民运一样，一直让城域这么一个制度，枯水季节的时候，我们会收取一点点粪浴，授职村里管理员，让他协调这个老百姓的生产雨水。
从上到下，从中到右，哎，这个，懂了吧？
他们灌完以后，给我钱嘛，就差不多一亩，或者是一亩五，就是给我保管权的，管理费。哎，这个，我就记下来了嘛。
一到十号那个十一月份就开始种小麦、大麦。 蚕豆、豌豆之类的，这个时候是种玉米。因为我种之前就牧草会撒在地里，然后不沾锄，田里的秸秆啊都背回来，然后喂马、喂牛，哎呀，还有挤圈粉，然后又把这个圈粉又拿到田里。
我们这个地方的雨荪的或这几年水稻，就是停后，或者是第一层雨水，就是停后，后期的话就是雨水就越来越多。从这个种植的这个机构来看嘛，目前的话已经是有一些相应的变化。这个十年前和十年后都有些这个现在是种植荪稻的就越来越少。
我们看起来今年怎么样？只有他一个人在跑这个跑水种，就是说，
年轻人不在家了，村子里边只有这个有些这个老年人了，就是管理不效。
招教主是一年比一年多，老批主，我们。
我们每个人都是要求采炼高的那种，所以老皮族是基本上是没人住了。他们这些有一些这种老品种啊，就直接就跟咱们的纳西的一些文化呀、一些生计啊，就息息相关了。咱们石头城村原来一直都有的一种做麻布衣服的一种作物，然后这个作物就消失了，因为咱们纳西族的话。 不管是说是给老人送终啊，还是做其他一些大的那种活动啊，基本上是需要这种麻布的，比方是祭天啊这些东西。所以说，就是去年的时候，他们就把这个品种给其他村里边找回来了，然后把这个古老的这个仿麻布的这个技术又给它恢复过来了。 从生物学的角度来说，生物多样性是持续就把植被啊，把整个这个农耕东西往下延续的一个很核心的东西。如果这些品种的流失啊，作物的流失变得特别单一的话，那它不管是应对这种气候变化也好，和应对这个整个那种市场经济啊和各种各样的变化、啊、往前走啊，它就没有很强的那种应对力了。这次活动呢，想把我们这个石头城一个相对完整那么一个纳西一个农耕的村子，跟我们比较遥远的马铃薯公园，他们那个也是印加民族为了保护文化生物多样性的一个模式，把这两个模式连在一块，希望这样的连接会对其他的山地社区有更大的影响。
Because of rapid changes in society, making farmers to rethink and redo their traditional farming practices, I think it's becoming even more important that to bring something closer to the reality of the farmers and to give it into their own hands, to have them, to make them manage their seeds in a better way and in a more collective way. And then over time, community seed banks started to do many different things, not only conserving seeds, but also exchanging seeds. And now some community seed banks are also producing and selling seeds of traditional varieties and sometimes of varieties improved through participatory plant breeding, for example, here in China.
那个桂农七百，桂农七百特别好。首先把玉米田里选，包里又选一次，然后在壳里再选一次的。这是幺三年的时候，我垂下那个地下里的，就是这样，我把垂，就是里边有三层。你交换之后的种子在外地种植的时候？就是我把这个已经洗好了，这个不能丢。就是我修理的种子分享到尼泊尔国家的，然后我把我的名字和我的地址和我的种类的名称都写好。
然后他们会给我反馈的。所以我们为了让这个农户能够去种老品种，然后我们就给农户说，我们把价格提高到翻一番，这样算下来的话，他就和新品种得到的收益就差不多了。这样的话。 还是能够提高一些积极性。我们会尽量在市场定位的时候，就是我们要去找喜欢传统文化知识的人，喜欢老品种的这种人在哪里。我们要通过一些通过互联网，通过淘宝，或者说通过一些论坛、一些社群，我们把这部分找过来。
In the climate change field, it has already been realized that the use of traditional knowledge and the recognition of biocultural heritage is the most effective way by which we can deal with climate change, especially in the adaptation field. With the indigenous peoples lie a lot of the resources, both biophysical as well as cultural and spiritual, that actually makes any effort at adaptation more effective and more sustainable.
Mountain communities are often isolated communities, marginalized communities. But in a time of global change, where we see rapid development and increase impacts on communities because of resource extraction, mountain communities need to network because the problems that happen in one mountain are similar to other mountains. And because at the same time of the importance of mountain ecosystems as a water towers, providers of food, key biodiversity, and other ecosystem services, the role of mountain communities has become more important, not just for resource management, but to provide solutions for the world.
This collaboration between China and other countries should be based in respecting very, very carefully what the countries needs and how the countries themselves present the proposals to these funds or these opportunities of collaboration that the Chinese government has announced in COP21, the fund for climate change and the fund for SDG achievement at the international level. And using these tools, try to develop a stronger relationship between our governments, between our countries.
I think one of the things I like about this event here is that we have all types of people interacting. So not only farmer to farmer or researcher to researcher, but everybody's talking to everybody. And so I think that is really, really something powerful. And this is also building the links that are necessary from the local to the higher and between different sectors.
It's in your blood. You know how these mountains behave, how this weather goes, you know. What really grows and what really doesn't grow, and to keep trying, you know, it's we'll trade seeds, we'll trade information, but at the end we will have, you know, best quality of life.